Hi, my name is Annika, and I'm a second-year student studying electrical engineering at the University of Colorado Boulder. Today, we're going to learn about waves and wave properties. Why are we able to see? We can see because there's light. And what is light? Well, light is a wave. So then, what is a wave? Well, we will learn the answer to that question today. Have you ever gotten a sunburn? Or used a microwave to make popcorn? Or had an x-ray taken? Or listened to the radio? What do these activities have in common? Well, all of these require waves. One difference between the waves to pop popcorn and the waves to tan your skin is the wave frequency. The frequency of a wave is defined as the number of cycles that pass a single point in a given amount of time. A wave is a disturbance that carries energy from one place to another. Matter is not carried with the wave. A wave can move through matter, which is called a medium. But some waves do not need a medium to be able to move. If a wave needs a medium, we call it a mechanical wave. If a wave can travel without a medium, for example, through space, we call it an electromagnetic wave. There are two types of waves, transverse and longitudinal waves. Transverse waves are waves in which the medium moves at right angles to the direction of the wave. Think about when spectators do a stadium wave. The people are moving up and down, but the wave is going around the stadium. A transverse wave has a crest and a trough. The crest is the highest point of the wave, and the trough is the lowest point of the wave. Longitudinal waves, also called compressional waves, are waves in which the medium moves back and forth in the same direction as the wave. While a transverse wave has a crest and a trough, longitudinal waves have compressions and rarefactions. A compression is where the particles are close together, and a rarefaction is where the particles are spread apart. Waves also have different properties associated with them. Wave properties depend on what type of energy makes the wave. These wave properties include wavelength, frequency, amplitude, and wave speed. Let's dive a little deeper into each of these properties. Wavelength is the distance between one point on a wave and the exact same place on the next wave. Frequency is how many waves go past a point in 1 second. The unit measurement of frequency is hertz. The higher the frequency, the more energy in the wave. For example, if 10 waves go past in 1 second, it is 10 hertz. If 1,000 waves go past in 1 second, it is 1,000 hertz. If 1,000,000 waves go past, it is 1,000,000 hertz. Amplitude is how far the medium, crests and troughs, or compressions and rarefactions, move from the rest position. The rest position is the place the medium is when not moving. The more energy a wave carries, the larger its amplitude. The energy of a wave can be expressed by the equation E is equal to CA squared, where E is energy, C is a constant dependent upon the medium, and A is amplitude. Wave speed depends on the medium in which the wave is traveling. It varies in solids, liquids, and gases. A mathematical way to calculate wave speed is wave speed is equivalent to wavelength times frequency, or V is equal to F times lambda. So if a wave has a wavelength of 2 meters and a frequency of 500 hertz, what is its speed? If you got that the wave speed is 1,000 meters per second, then you're correct. Additionally, waves don't only travel in one direction, they can also change direction. There are three methods in which a wave can change direction. They can change due to reflection, refraction, and diffraction. Reflection is when waves bounce off a surface. If the surface is flat, the angle at which the wave hits the surface will be the same as the angle that the wave leaves the surface. In other words, the angle in equals the angle out. This is the law of reflection. Let's take a pool table for example. When a pool ball strikes the side of a pool table, the angle at which it hits the bumper is the same angle at which it bounces off the bumper. Refraction is how waves can bend. This happens when a wave enters a new medium and its speed changes. The amount of bending depends on the medium it is entering. Diffraction is the bending of waves around an object. The amount of bending depends on the size of the obstacle and the size of the waves. If there's a large obstacle, but the wave has a small wavelength, that means that there is low diffraction, it bends less. If there's a small obstacle and the wave has a large wavelength, then the wave has a large diffraction. It bends more. Now that you're all experts in understanding the different types of waves, how they move and change direction, and how to describe their characteristics, what are some of the ways that you see waves used in your everyday lives? Some examples are microwave ovens, medical and dental x-ray machines, eyeglasses, and speakers. These are common examples where engineers apply their knowledge of waves to design all types of useful products and tools that are evident in our everyday lives. To design these products, engineers must be well-versed in all the properties of waves and how waves can differ from one another. For example, the waves emitted from a microwave are very different from those emitted from an x-ray machine that create images of bones or teeth. Engineers need a complete understanding of wave properties in order to design safe and effective products. But that's not all. Engineers work to protect people and predict how tsunamis will travel after an earthquake in the ocean by using wave properties. To successfully predict where a tsunami will travel, engineers must understand how waves move and the properties associated with waves. Another example of engineers using wave properties is when electrical engineers separate different types of waves so that the radio you're using tunes into the right station, or your cell phone only picks up the calls that you want. If it were not for these engineers, you would constantly be getting calls from people you didn't know. To accomplish this, they must have a clear understanding of wave properties and know how to separate different types of waves. Before designing and creating a solution to a challenge, engineers conduct research and gather information, just like you did today. This step is a crucial part of the engineering design process. Check out the lesson on the Teach Engineering website and then apply what you learned about waves and wave properties in our associated hands-on activity, Developing and Presenting Design Solutions, Waves Go Public.